Hello everyone, welcome back to watercolour class. Today we're doing sparrows in hawthorn. So without any further ado, let's get started. The drawing for this painting is available on my website at karenstudio.co.uk on the online demos page. So go ahead and download that, especially if you're not that confident about drawing. So I've sketched it out onto my paper, and I will just put up a list of all the equipment that you will need. Before we start painting, I'm going to reserve a few areas with masking fluid. So you can either use the fluid and use a cocktail stick or one of these ruling pens to put it on, or you could use an old paintbrush, but don't use your good ones because it will ruin them. For finer details, you could always use one of these, which is the Pebbio drawing gum pen, which are great for doing fine details. So I'll start by putting some of the details on. So on the flowers, we've got some fine stamens with some little pink ends to them. So if we just put a few dots and a few stamens on some of our flowers. Now, using a large brush, I've got some ultramarine blue here. I'm just going to pop that in around the outer areas. While that's still nice and wet, I've mixed up some indigo blue, which I'm now going to feed through the middle. Nice rich colour around the birds. I'm using some of the indigo. And some of the sap green to make a dark green shade. We'll pop some of the background leaves in. These are not the ones you've drawn in. These are just some background ones between some of the flowers. And again, you just let that run in. Using a very pale mix of the indigo, really, really watery. We're just going to put a little bit of shadow on the birds' bellies. Got a little bit of light red, or you could use burnt sienna. And again, watery mix. We're now going to put it on the birds' backs. While it's damp, I'm going to mix a little bit of that light red with some of the indigo and just pop in a little bit of a bit more paint in that. I'm just going to work in between some of the flowers now, just to bring some of them out a little bit. mix of the sap green, quite thin now. We're just going to paint in some of the other leaves. If you paint some of it and then just add water to some, so we don't end up with a flat looking leaf. Well, it's all dry. I'll take off the masking fluid. Right, we're going to put some pink dots in now where the end of the stamens are. Right, with a little bit of yellow now, just put in some yellow centres. And then a little bit of watered down ultramarine blue, pop one or two shadows in. Okay, and a few final touches, getting eyes, legs, branches in, a little bit of detail on the beaks. Okay. Well, I think that's finished. I hope you've enjoyed painting along with me today. If you did, please hit the subscribe button, and if you click the bell, you will get notifications of new videos going up. So hopefully you'll have a go at this, and happy painting.